say we love you, Lord.
Father, we lay our lives before your throne. He is ready to bless the Lord in this place, to give him praise, to give him worship. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I will bless the Lord. I will praise his name. For the rest of my life,
for the rest of my life,
forever proclaim,
I'm forever.
Praise the Lord, hallelujah. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank God for such a time as this. I trust that you are blessed. I pray that the grace of God, the favor of God, the hand of God will be upon you in Jesus' name. As we get in today's study, I want to say welcome to every one of you, wherever you are, that today's study will truly be a blessing to you in Jesus' name. We just had our 13th anniversary, which was awesome. It was magnificent. We thank God for his grace, for his favor, for his kindness, for his goodness in our lives. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. So I pray that in this tonight's study, that you will actually hear the voice of God. Not just the voice of man, but you will hear the voice of God in Jesus' name. I pray that the Lord will speak to you. I pray that the Lord will strengthen you. In Jesus' name. Father, we thank you. We bless your name. We magnify your name for your faithfulness, for your grace, and for your favor. Scripture says the entrance of your word brings life and understanding to the simple. Minister to each one of us tonight. Father, touch our lives, change our lives, transform our lives. Do what only you can do for your glory and for your honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And everybody says, amen and amen. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Hallelujah. Welcome one more time in Jesus' name. We continue with the series we started last week on manifesting the sonship of God. Manifesting the sonship of God. Thank you, Brother Freddy, for letting me know that now you're facing, in case you can't hear the sound very well on YouTube, I'm I'm sure you can on Facebook. Thanks for that. So here we are. We started a new series last week titled Manifesting the Sonship of God. The Sonship of God. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to know the only way you can stop the enemy, the only way you can stop the enemy is when you operate as a son of God. It's when you operate as a son of God, not just as a son of man, but as a son of God. And there is a difference. There is a massive difference. As children of the Most High God, sons and daughters of God, we must operate as sons and daughters of God, not as sons and daughters of men. There's a whole lot of different experiences when we do that. As long as you stay only on the level of the son of man or daughter of man, as long as you remain on that level, you will always come short. You will always come short as long as you remain on that level, the level of the son of man or the level of the daughter of man. You will always come short or be limited in progress in whatever it is you do. Satan wants you to engage him on the third dimension. By third dimension, I mean this natural first dimension, second dimension, third dimension. You know, when you look at the picture, it's a one dimension. When then we started drawing, you have two dimensions, which is the elevation and the side or the top and the side or the top at the back, etc. Two dimensions. And then there is the perspective, which is the three dimension. But beyond the three dimension that gives you three different views at the same time in perspective, beyond that is the fourth dimension, which is the spirit dimension. Satan would always want you to look at life, operate in life in first dimension, second dimension, and in the third dimension. But our call is not to engage him on the first dimension, because there is blindness there, not even on the second or the third dimension. We are to engage him on the fourth dimension, and that there lies your victory 24/7 all of the time. Glory be to God. You see, in the third dimension, there is struggle. In the first, second, or third dimensions, there are struggles. So, you know, so struggle and the feeling of powerlessness and sometimes hopelessness. Because you see, you just can't win on that level. You just cannot win on that level because that's the enemy's turf. That's Satan's ground. You can't win on that level. In the third dimension, Satan is king, whether you like it or not. In the third dimension, in the first dimension, second dimension, in the third dimension, Satan is king. So he has rights. He has rights to do as he pleases. He has rights to do. If you don't believe it, look at what the scripture says in Luke. Luke chapter 4. Let me get this slide up so that you can see what I am talking about. Luke chapter 4 verse 5-7. Luke chapter 4 verse 5-7. Luke chapter 4 5-7 in the Message translation. This is, for the second test he led him up and spread out all the kingdoms of the earth on display at once. This in itself is a spiritual feat, for you to see the kingdom of the earth all at once. Then the devil said, they are yours in all their splendor to serve your pleasure. I'm in charge of them all and can turn them over to whomsoever I wish. Worship me and they are yours, the whole works. Worship me and they are yours, the whole works. So we see that Satan claims ownership. He claims ownership. And he even had the audacity to show the Lord that the kingdoms of this world and the pleasures of it, everything belongs to him. And he will give it to anyone that he pleases it. Anyone that pleasures him, he has the power to give the kingdoms of this world to anyone that he pleases. Satan offered Jesus what was already his. Can you believe it? The world and all that's in it, and all, everything in it, Satan was offering Christ, was offering Jesus. Forget that he's God in the flesh to begin with. He was offering Jesus, the whole world, offering him rulership of the whole world at the cost of his soul. And Jesus told us, what does it profit a man, or indeed a woman, if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? What shall a man give in exchange for his soul? And here was Satan tempting the Lord, trying to get him to miss his calling, to miss his mission. And said, oh, he showed him all the kingdom, that in itself is a supernatural feat. That he was able, because in the spirit there is no time, there's no limit, there's no time-wise, it's eternity. Jesus was able to see everything in a split second and then offered it to him on the platter. All you need to do is bow down and worship me, and all of this will be yours. All you have to do is worship. Worship me, and everything you've seen just now will be yours. Of course, we know the end of the story. Get thee behind me, Satan. You know, the Lord of God is the only one that you worship. Satan has power to give wealth. That is the reality of life that we have to deal with. Satan has power to give wealth. He has power to give riches. He has power to give wealth. He has power on earth to give riches, power to promote, power to elevate. He has power to elevate. He has power to promote. He has tremendous power, but at the cost of your soul. At the cost of your soul. Jesus told us, as I said before, what does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? And what shall it profit a man? You know, so he said that. So you see, what he's saying basically, that if it was possible to take all the treasures of this world and put it on one side of the scale, and then take one soul, one man, woman, put it on the other side of the scale, that man will still outweigh everything the world has to offer in terms of the value of that life. God is saying there is nothing on planet Earth, nothing on any planet for that matter, that is comparable to your value. Comparable to your value. And that's what Satan was trying to do. Exchange authority, exchange power for pleasure, for treasure. He said, I am in charge of them all. I am in charge of them all and can turn them over to whomsoever I wish. I have them under my control. I can turn them, I can give it to whomsoever. I can give it to whomsoever I wish, whomsoever I desire, I can give it to them. That's what he's saying. You know, Satan has power to give wealth. He has power to give riches. And that's why some people flock in that direction. But there is a price for everything. The Bible tells us right there in Luke chapter 4, verse 6. In the English Standard Version, it says right there, and he said to him, to you I will give all. Oh, let me go back. Okay, Luke 4:6 in the English Standard Version of the Bible. And said to him, to you I will give all this authority or power and their glory, for it has been delivered to me, and I give it to whom I will. I guess it says, for it has been delivered to me. What does it mean? It says, for it has been delivered to me. Of course. You know where he got it from? He got it from Adam and Eve. When Adam and Eve disobeyed God, they relinquished their authority to Satan. Satan has all rights. He has all authority and power in this world, and that's why he said, it's been delivered to me. He has that authority, he has that power. Satan has rights. Satan has rights, so much so are the rights of the sons and daughters of God. Satan has rights. But so much more are the rights of the sons and daughters of the Most High God. Remember, we are in this world, we are not of this world. Jesus himself said one time, the prince of this world comes but finds nothing in me. Basically, what he's saying is that Satan might be the prince of this world for a season. but he doesn't have to be the prince of my life. Oh, glory to God. That's a beautiful thing. Yes, Satan may have all the power, he may have all the authority on planet Earth, but he doesn't have to have any power over us, over you. He doesn't have to have any power as long as you walk in the third, in the fourth dimension. Satan would have no power over you. You become an enigma. Oh, glory be to God. That's who God has called us to be. That's what it means to manifest as the sons of God. Manifesting as the sons and daughters of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says in John 1:10-13. John 10:1-13. Let me see. Okay. Let me see if I can. John 1:10-13. In the New American Bible Revised Edition. John 1:10-13. He was in the world, and the world He was in the world, and the world came to be through him. But the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, but his own people did not accept him. But to those who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of the, by natural generation, nor by human choice, nor by man's decision, but of God. Those who are not born of the flesh, born of the blood, but born by the decision of God. He gave power to those who receive him. He gave power. He gave the right to become the sons of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. When you give your life to Christ, when you accept Christ in your life, you receive the right. You receive the power, you receive the authority to become a son of God, to become a daughter of God, to operate as a son of God, to operate as a daughter of God. That means you come out of the rulership of Satan into the kingdom of light, into the kingdom of God, where you walk under the power, or you walk by the power of God. Glory to God. That's what happened to you when you gave your life to Christ. You are translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of God, into the kingdom of light. Glory be to God. The power is given. That power given to become the son of God, that power given to become a daughter of God, was not given to comply. It was not given to comply. It's given so that you don't have to comply with the systems of this world. You don't have to comply with the structures of this world, but to overcome it. The power, the right, the capacity, the ability to become a son of God, that empowerment to become a daughter of God is given to us for us to be able to overcome every limitation this world has to present us. In other words, we can break through every barrier of the enemy to operate as the sons of God, because we are now different. We're not just sons of men now, we are now sons of God. Oh, glory be to God. We are now sons of God. Hallelujah. Power is given to overcome limitations and frustrations of this world. When you become a son of God, God gives you power. God gives you ability. God gives you access to his throne for you to be able to receive strength to overcome the frustrations of the world, to overcome the frustration of the world, the limitations of this world. That's why you need the power. That's why you need to operate as a son of God, not as a son of man. As long as you operate as a son of man, Satan will always have the upper hand. Satan will always have the upper hand. But the Bible tells us that even creation groans, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. So it's absolutely important, ladies and gentlemen, your victory is when you begin to walk and operate as son or daughter of God, not just as sons and daughters of men. Absolutely important. Power was given, or is given, to the sons and daughters of God to disrupt systems, to disrupt structure, to disrupt the status quo, In other words, you don't fit in. Oh, glory be to God. That power to become a son of God, a daughter of God, is to show that you don't fit in. So when disaster comes in, it may take away others, it won't take you away, because you are peculiar, because you are unique, you are different. You are operating on a different level. That's why it says 1,000 may fall on your right side, 10,000, you know, on your side. Only with your eyes you will see. Why? Because you are different. You are operating as a son of God. You are operating as a daughter of God. The benefit is limitless. Your victory is when you operate as the son of God. Your victory is in operating as a daughter of God, not just as a son of man. As a son of man, they were wailing in the wilderness. They are facing difficulty. They were wailing in the wilderness. But Moses was not wailing. Aaron was not wailing. The rest of them were not wailing. Why? Because they were, although in the Old Testament, they were operating as sons of God. Oh, glory be to God. Sons of God will get water out of the rock. Sons of God will face the status quo in a different way, will operate on a different level. Sons of God have a different worldview. Our calling is not to operate as sons of men, but as sons of God. You can go to the same interview with the sons of men, but because you are the son of God, you get the job. Oh, glory be to God. You may not be the most qualified person, but because you operate as the son of God, those who came behind you operating as sons of men, you will take their place. Because this thing is a mystery. Glory be to God. The call of God upon your life is not just to operate as son of man, but to operate as son of God. Power is given to break free from the norm. When you become a son of God, when you become a daughter of God, you receive power to break free from the norm. You receive power to break free from the regular. You receive power to break through to break free from the ordinary. Your life becomes extraordinary. Glory be to God. As a matter of fact, your life becomes supernatural, because now you are living in the God, you know, dimension, not just in the sons of men's dimension. Power is necessary, and power is given to the sons and daughters of God so they can stand firm in the storms of life. Oh, glory be to God. Power is given to the sons of men. When you receive power, the right, the authority to become a son of God, a daughter of God, is a whole package you receive. It's a lifetime, eternal package that you receive. Glory be to God. It's like manna that meets every need. So you see, power is given. When you give your life to Christ, power is given to you. The right is given to you. The capacity is given to you to function. Not just to function, but to be a son of God, or to be a daughter of God, so you can stand firm in the storms of life. You can stand firm in the storms of life. What's taking other people down will not take you down, because you can stand firm in the storms of life. You have the power to stand firm in the storm of life. You have power to stand sure in the storms of life. You have the power to stand out. Oh, glory be to God, in this wicked world. What is taking other people down will not take you down. Why? Because you are operating as the son of God. Most of the problem is that sons of God were trying to operate as the sons of men. And as long as you operate as son of God, you will always come short. As long as you are operating as a son of man, you will always come short. Because sons of men operate, you know, they have different kinds of skills, abilities. It's all over the places. The struggle continues with the sons of men. No, but the Bible says the steps of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. When you operate as a son of God, as a daughter of God, God is in charge of your steps. You will never fail. You can never fail. Glory be to God. When you operate as sons of God, as daughters of God, you are able to love the way God loves. Our calling is to operate not just as sons of men, but to operate as sons of God. Oh, glory be to God. That's the calling upon your life. Don't measure your life with somebody else. You are called to be either a son of God or a daughter of God. As a matter of fact, it's actually the son of God, meaning that you have the same capacity. You have the same gene. You have the same makeup as God himself. Just like a crumb of bread has the same chemical composition as indeed a loaf of bread. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So power is given to the sons and daughters of God so they can shine. Oh, glory be to God. So they can shine you can shine forth as light. Power is given to sons of God so they can shine. They can shine bright as light in this world, in this world of darkness. Power is given to sons and daughters of God to be salt on earth, to be salt on earth with the word of God, in order to reverse the decay and the corruption in our world. That is in the remit and the domain of the sons and daughters of God. Sons of men can't help it. The best they can do is groan. The best is they can do is moan. But sons of God take charge. Power is given to us to change situations. Power is given to us to change circumstances. Power is given to us to say no to the regular, no to the normal. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Power is given to us to become light. Bible says a city set on a hill cannot be hidden. Your light will not be hidden in Jesus' name. Jesus says that we are the salt of the earth. You will not lose your savor in Jesus' name. So we are given power. We are given power, Holy Ghost power, to effect a change, to reject the normal, to reject the ordinary. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. To stop the enemy in his tracks. Power. Just like God empowered them at the Passover in those days in Egypt, when the children of God were told to put blood on the lintel and on the doorpost, and when they put that blood there, when the angel of God came, he was killing everyone, but wherever he saw the blood, that was the sign, a sign of the sonship, that the people who live in this place are covered. They have a covenant with God. Excuse me. Death passed over because they had a covenant with God. They were sons and daughters of God. What take other people down will not take you down. When the water of destruction came, Noah and his family was lifted up by the same water that destroyed the whole nation. Why? Because they operated as sons of God, as daughters of God. That is going forward, never forget it. The call of God upon your life is to operate as son of God, as sons or daughters of God. As long as you are operating as sons and daughters of men, you will always be under the control of the elements of the world. The enemy will always afflict you. Haven't you noticed? The children of God forgot who they were in the wilderness, and because of that, they were operating as sons of men, even though they were sons of God. And what happened? They were always groaning, they were always moaning, they were always complaining, etc. People who complain, people who are always moaning and complaining, check it. They are living. They may be in church. They may be in church, they may profess to be Christians, but they are just operating below their level. They are operating below the sonship of God. They are operating as sons of men. Full stop. Full stop. But there's a call upon your life to operate as sons of God. Glory be to God, sons of God. You are the light of this world. You are the salt of this earth. To put an end to the moral decay, spiritual decay of the time and season in which we live. The Bible says in Romans 8 verse 9 in the King James Version of the Bible, it says, "For the earnest expectation of creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God." For the earnest expectation, they are waiting eagerly. Eagerly, creature is waiting. Every creation of God is waiting. Every creation in their various dimensions, in their various realms. The trees is a form of life. They talk to each other. They communicate. The birds, the animal, the wildlife, everyone in their own group. They are waiting. They are waiting eagerly for the expectations for the manifestation of the sons of God, the daughters of God, because they want redemption as well. They want redemption, and it starts with men. Oh, glory be to God. It starts with humans. It starts with us, sons of God. When we are fully restored, creation also will benefit from that regeneration. Glory be to God. This is for the earnest expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. So creature is waiting to see what these sons of God is like, what they are like among the sons of men. You see, the word earnest expectation is single. It's a single word in Greek, and it's a very strange one. It means literally straining forward. With outstretched head to seeing something. So creation is waiting. The creature is waiting for the manifestation. They are straining forward to see what the sons of God are like, what the daughters of God are like. We've seen the sons of men. We know what the daughters of men are like. But what are these sons of God? What are they like? What are the daughters of God? What are they like? You know, this is why you are saved. This is why you are transformed, so that your life can demonstrate what the life of one that is a son of God, the life of one that is a daughter of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. The expression, manifestation of the sons of God means the appearance. Creature is waiting for the appearance. The appearance, the display, the exhibition, expression, the materialization and revelation of the sons and daughters of God. They are waiting expectantly. They are straining forward to see what kind of people are these. What breed of people are like are these? Oh, glory be to Jesus. We see that Jesus defeated Satan not just as a son of man, but also as a son of God, and there is a difference. Glory be to God. When Jesus defeated Satan, he didn't just defeat him as a son of man, but he also defeated him as the son of God. Remember that God gave Jesus what I call PDA. God gave Jesus a PDA, public display of affection, when he was baptized. He made a proclamation when he said, "This is my beloved son. I have sons, but this one is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased." Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. God gave Jesus PDA, public display of affection. The people on that day at the River Jordan heard it. They heard that statement clearly, and Satan heard it too. Satan heard that statement, and I believe he was eating through with jealousy. He was eating through with jealousy, and he was set to destroy him, try to destroy him, that this new kid on the block is going to be trouble if I don't sort him out. And we know that Jesus, the Holy Spirit took Jesus to the wilderness to pray and fast. And the Bible tells us when he was hungry, at the end of the 40 days and 40 nights of praying, you know, Satan is strategic. He's not a fool. He didn't come first day of Jesus' fasting. He didn't come day 5, day 10, day 20, day 30. He didn't come day 35, 39. He came on day 40 when Jesus was physically at the weakest point. That's when he came and tried and tested him. Because he said, "Okay, fine, if you are the son of God," God said, "This is my beloved son." Okay, if you are the son of God yourself, then turn these stones to bread. Three temptations, but Jesus overcame. He overcame. The only way to overcome the enemy, the only way to take charge, is to operate as a son of God, to operate as a daughter of God. I don't know what you are facing. I don't know what you have been dealing with. I don't know what challenges you have been going through. Maybe you've been approaching this thing as a son of man, and therefore you are getting the results men, the sons of men, get. Why? Because you have been limited by what limits the sons of men. You have been limited by what limits the sons or the daughters of men. I come to challenge you this morning to change the play field. Oh, glory be to God. Because you see, if you continue on that path, you will not overcome. If you continue in that path, you will not win. You will not get to where you want to. That's where the enemy wants you to. This is a wake-up call for you. You can't win going in that direction. You have to operate as the son of God that you are. You have to operate as the daughter of God that you are, and then you will see the back of the devil, and then you will see the back of whatever challenge has come your way. So the only way to overcome the challenges, the limitations, the difficulties or frustrations of this world, the only way to take charge is to operate as sons of God. There is nothing as beautiful as being in charge. When you are in charge, when you call the shots, oh glory be to God, the world will bow to you. The world will bow to you in your career, in your profession, in your field. When you call the shot, people will listen to you. People will listen to you. Glory be to God. You will not be frustrated in Jesus' name. Akara, you will not surrender to difficulties. You will not give in to frustration in Jesus' name. So move away from operating near as sons of men, as daughters of men. No, begin to operate as sons of God and see Satan leave you alone. Glory be to God. When Jesus said, "Get behind me," Satan left him alone. He left him alone completely because he knew that this one is not operating as a son of man. He's operating as son of God. Therefore, I have no authority over him. I have no dominion over him. The only way to thrive in this Babylonish system is to operate as sons of God. You didn't hear me. The only way to thrive, to flourish, in this Babylonish economy, Babylonish system, way of life, structures and system of men, the only way to flourish and to thrive is to operate as sons and daughters of God. Oh, glory be to God. When you operate as the son of God, there are resources beyond comprehension. Everything is available wherever you are. Glory be to God. When you operate as a son of God, every of the element answers to you. When you operate as sons of God, doors must open. When you operate as sons of God, every season becomes your season. Oh, glory be to God. When you operate as sons of God, there is no limitation. It's as far as you desire to go as a child of God. So you must come out of operating as sons of men. Sons of men have limitations. It's crowded at the bottom. Oh, glory be to God. When you begin to walk in your right as sons and daughters of God, the challenges you are dealing with at this level will be your footstool. Will be a footstool to where you are going. You become unlimited. You become unlimited. You become unlimited. The only way to thrive in this system that we're living in, because those who came before you have established systems. They've established this. The positions are taken. And there are cues behind every position, and you just came. Who are you? Glory be to God. But when you begin to operate as sons of God and daughters of God, there has to be room for you. Who told you in the palace of Pharaoh when Joseph came on board? Who told you there was vacancy for the king's assistant? There was no vacancy. All the vacancy were taken. But Bible says a man's gift will make room for him. But when Joseph showed up and interpreted Pharaoh's dream, Pharaoh said to Joseph, "Only on the throne would I be greater than you. You'll be second in command to me. Only on the throne will I be greater to you." He says, all of Egypt is at your feet. You can do. No man lifts hand or foot in this Egypt except by your word. Why? Because Joseph was operating as son of God, as a son of God, to God be the glory. He was busy interpreting dreams everywhere. His gift made room for him. His gift made room for him. And all of a sudden, he found himself as second in command to the king, to Pharaoh of Egypt. That is supernatural. Supernatural. Glory be to God. So I thank God for your certificate, but it's not enough. It's not enough. Because the certificate you have, somebody has a better one. Oh, yes. The certificate you have, I say to people, if five people apply for one job and all of them had a distinction, all of the five has a distinction, that means that even if the interviewer closes his eyes or her eyes and point to any one of those five, any one of them, apparently, will be competent enough to do whatever job that they're hired to do. So when you have five and you only have one seat, what happens? That is where those who operate as sons of God emerge. That's where they are separate from the pack. Oh, glory be to God. May the grace of God distinguish you. May the power of God distinguish you. May the anointing of God distinguish you. May the blood of Jesus distinguish you. Put your head and shoulder above the rest, like it did in Babylon in the days of Shadrach. No, in the days of Daniel, Meshach, Abednego, and the other one. Glory be to God. They were 10 times better than the rest because of the grace of God, because of the Spirit of God that was on the inside of them. They operated. In fact, they called them the sons of gods. The Spirit of God is in them. They operated as sons of God, not just as sons of men. Don't misunderstand me. Operating as sons of men will get you somewhere. Will get you somewhere, but it can only go so far. Operating as sons of God has no limit. Oh, glory be to God. Operating as sons and daughters of God has no limit. So there's no limit to how far you can go, ladies and gentlemen. There's no limit to how far you can go, to how far you can achieve. There's no limit as long as you operate as sons or daughters of God. Bible tells us in Psalm 110, verse 1 to 2. This is a Psalm of David. The Lord said to my Lord, at my right hand, till I make your enemies your footstool. The Lord shall send the rod of your strength out of Zion. Rule in the midst of your enemies. Oh, glory be to God. I wish I had time to spend on this one. He says, rule in the midst of your enemies. That is the sons of and daughters of God. That is what they are able to do. They are able to rule. To rule. Glory be to God. They are able to take charge even in the midst of their enemies. They are able to take charge. Why? Because they are operating not as sons of men, but as sons of God. What is true about Jesus here is also true about us. God's will for us is to draw strength from His throne, from Zion, from the church, through the Zion, with power to rule in the midst of our enemies. God's will is to draw strength from Him continuously, so that we can have the power to rule in the midst of our enemies. He says to the Lord, this is the Spirit, this is David talking in the Spirit. The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstool. In other words, this is not your fight. I will fight your battles for you. When you become a son of God, God takes on your battle. Oh, glory be to God. When you become a son of God, God takes on your fight. When you become a daughter of God, it takes on your fight, it takes on your battle. Glory be to God. Quit operating as sons of men that just look at things only purely from the human perspective and no further. I want you to know that your victory is in when you begin to operate as sons of God, as daughters of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. That can only be done as sons. You can only rule in the midst of your enemy as sons or daughters of God, because we are signs and wonders in this world. Every daughter of God is a sign to the world, to this present generation, that Yahweh lives, that God lives. Jesus says, I and the children that God has given me, we are for signs and wonder in Israel. Glory be to God. That is what your life is meant to be. That is what my life is meant to be. People seeing us operating as sons and daughters of God. So we become signs, a sign to the kingdom of God, a sign to God, so that people look at our life and they reflect on God. Oh, glory be to God. Our life pulls them to reflect on God, the Creator Himself. God making you a testimony. God making your life a testimony. You see, one of the elements I love about the sons and daughters of God is their disposition to disrupting protocols. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Sons and daughters of God are unique. I just like the fact that they're able to disrupt protocol, the norm. Right through scripture, you see it over and over again. It's just not normal. They, in this world, they display the power of God, the splendor of God. You see, ladies and gentlemen, sons and daughters of God don't take no for an answer. They don't take a no for an answer. They don't bow to the nose of men. Oh, glory be to God. Sons and daughters of God disrupt. They disrupt protocol or policies. They disrupt procedures to bring out the glory of God. They don't accept a no for an answer. For them, nothing is impossible. Oh, glory, sons and daughters of God. They have the mindset that nothing good is impossible. The sons and daughters of God only want to see God glorified. They want to see God magnified. And they will put their feet down. They want to see God glorified. They want to see God magnified here on earth. The sons and daughters of God. The sons and daughters of God. That's why we must manifest. You see, angels were once called the sons of God. Angels were once called sons of God in the Bible. We see that in Job 1 verse 6. Now, there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came among them. So the sons of God, angels, were first called sons of God. They were called sons of God. They were called sons of God. But you have to understand, the sons of God here are angels, servants, and messengers of God. They were servants, they were messengers of God, even though they were called sons of God. Whatever your theology is on this one, angels are sons of God and are not sons of God in the way believers, that is you and I, are. And when the Bible calls angels sons of God in the Old Testament, etc., it is not in the same sense that we are the sons of God. There is a massive difference. Why? Because to begin with, angels, even though they were called the sons of God, were not created in the image and likeness of God in the way mankind was. So you see, that puts us in a different class altogether. Yes, the angels were called sons of God, etc., you know, etc., but you see, they were not sons of God in the way that we are, because you and I, born again, or humanity generally, was created in the image and likeness of God. So that makes us different. Angels may come from the same source as man, but they do not share the nature or DNA of God as man does. Oh, glory to God. I just wish you get that one. Yes, God is our maker, as indeed the maker of angels. Angels came from God, just like we came from God. But you see, they are coming from God is so limited as compared to us, because we carry the DNA of God. We carry the nature of God. Oh, glory be to God. We carry the nature of God. So when we say we are sons of God, it's not in the same realm as the angels are in the Bible. Paul the Apostle says in Romans 8:19 in the King James Version, he says, For the earnest expectations of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. So the sons of God here spoken of is not the angelic being. Rather, it's talking about the regenerated man or the regenerated woman that has been given the right and the power to become sons and daughters of God. Those are the ones that creature is waiting eagerly for, to see their revelation, their unveiling, their exposition, to see their manifestation. To God be the glory. And I tell you what, creation is in for a show. Oh, hallelujah. As soon as we get our acts together and we all know who we are, and we begin to manifest the manifold wisdom of God, the many sides of God, creation is in for a show. Oh, glory be to God. Creature, including angels, are in for a show. To God be the glory. I believe not only is the creature waiting, the angels too are waiting. The angels too are watching for the revelation and the exposure of the sons and daughters of God. Because you see, we are at a different level to angels. We are at a different level to angels. Yes, angels are amazing. They are swift. They are fiery beings. They are physically, when we talk about physical strength, they are infinitely superior to men. Glory be to God. But it's not about that. It's about positioning. Oh, glory be to God. It's about the nature we share with God. The nature that we share with God. So they are waiting eagerly too, along with creatures, to see what these sons of God, what these daughters of God, what they are supposed to be like. The Bible calls these sons and daughters of God peculiar people. Oh, glory be to God. It says that these sons of God, they are not ordinary. These daughters of God, they are not ordinary. 1 Peter 2:9 tells us. 1 Peter 2:9 in the King James Version says, "But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light." Glory be to God in the highest. So here we are. Apostle Peter is telling the church that ye are a chosen generation. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people. That so many superlatives just to describe who we are, who the sons and daughters of God are. Oh, glory be to God. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. We are so unique, we are so special, we should show forth the glory, the praise of the one that called us, that translated us from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. Because creature is waiting, creature is watching, angels are waiting, angels are watching to see the manifestation. Why did God go through all this? What is so unique about these people called sons and daughters of God? Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. You know, angels are ministering spirit called to minister to the saints. They are our servants. Angels, as terrific as they are, awesome as they are, powerful as they are our servants. Scripture calls them ministering spirit. That again tells us that we are not on the same level when it comes to the sonship of God. You cannot afford to be normal. Mm-mm-mm-mm. You cannot afford to be regular. You cannot afford to be typical or ordinary for that matter. It doesn't fit you. Oh, hallelujah. That is what Satan wants you to think. He wants you to think that you are ordinary. He wants you to think that you are typical. He wants you to think that you are regular. You are just normal. Normal being, just normal human being. But that is a lie. You are not. You, my brother, you, my sister, are supernatural. Oh, glory be to God. You are supernatural. Glory be to God. That's what Satan don't want you to think. He doesn't want you to think and to know how supernatural you are. So you can't afford to live a normal life. What does that mean? You can't afford to live a regular life. You can't afford to live a typical, ordinary life. No, there must be a difference. Oh, glory be to God. God said to the children of Israel in Egypt, he says, we're going to set a difference between him, between them and the children and the Egyptians. And he did that with light. For days, Goshen, where the children of Israel were, had light. For days, they had light. Even at night time, they had light. But the children of Egypt, the Egyptians rather, were in darkness. Even at noonday, they were in darkness. God put a difference between them. I pray that God will separate you, put a division between you and any negative thing around you, any negative thing in this society. I pray that God will make a difference between you and them. He will separate you, will separate your family. He will separate your family from every negative in this nation, every negative around us, in the name of Jesus. God is the God of difference. Oh, glory be to God. So we see that you can't afford to be normal. You can't afford to be regular, run of the mill. You can't afford to be typical. You cannot afford to be ordinary. It will not fit you. There is no testimony for that, for the man or woman that's just ordinary. It's a rollover. You just be rolled over all the time, taking advantage of. That is not your portion. We see in that scripture that it said the four ways. It said chosen generation, royal priesthood, holy nation, a peculiar people. That's who you are. That's who you are. God is saying that I am chosen. God is saying I am royal priesthood. God is saying I'm a holy person, holy nation. God is saying I'm a peculiar person. That's who God is saying you are. Oh, glory be to God. Satan doesn't want you to believe that. Satan doesn't want you to operate with that mindset. No. Sons and daughters of God are chosen. They are a chosen generation. They are chosen. Say with me, I am chosen. Oh, glory be to God. Yes, I am chosen. I am selected. I am God's elect. Say with me, I am God's elect. Say with me, I am chosen. Yes, you may not feel it, but say it until you feel it. You may not believe it, but say it until you believe it. You are chosen. Glory be to God. You are God's elect. He says you are the apple of his eyes. To God be the glory. You are chosen not only out of the world. You are chosen not only out of the nation. You are chosen not only out of your father's house. You are chosen for eternal salvation. Oh, glory be to God. God chose you for all eternity. God chose you for all eternity. He called you out of your father's house, out of your kindred, out of your nation. Glory to God. He called you to himself for all eternity. For all eternity. So you are chosen. Oh, glory be to God. That should excite your spirit, man. That is why our mindset must be different from that of the sons of men. Oh, glory be to God. Sons of men, come see, come saw, whatever happens, happen. But no. For sons of men, for sons of God, you must always win all the time. Glory be to God. As long as he's on the throne, it's not over until he says it's over. He has the final say. You have the final say as a son of God, as a daughter of God. To God be the glory. To have been chosen means there are those who were rejected. Those who were rejected because they rejected the invitation. Oh, glory be to God. They rejected the invitation that you and I accepted, and therefore they are rejected. Glory to God. We are not chosen because we are perfect, but are perfect because he chose us. Oh, glory be to God. He didn't choose us because, we are perfect, because we are better. No. It is because he chose us that we become perfect. He perfects us, having chosen us. Creating, creation is waiting. Angels are watching to see the mystery behind this calling. It's time to give them something to see. Ooh, glory to God. It's time to give them something to see. It's time for your life to demonstrate something to see. I'm talking about unusual testimonies. Unusual testimonies. Unusual breakthrough. Unusual solution. Unusual abnormal. Oh, something that would say, wow. Oh, glory be to God. Something that is inexplainable. Something that is inexplainable. That's what your life ought to be like. Don't surrender your life to situations. Don't surrender your life, your vision, your dream to circumstances. Under the circumstances, I can't do this. Under the circumstances, I can't do that. Come out of that circumstances and operate as the son of God that you are. Oh, glory to God. Operate as the son of God that you are. I remember several years ago, before I came into full time, finished my degree at that time, and the economy of the country was just down in the gutters. I mean, it was terrible. It was the days of Margaret Thatcher at the time, the Iron Fist lady, and that was it. It was terrible. The economy was had gone to the dogs. It was terrible. I mean, people were losing their houses, etc. And I just came into the job market. There was no job anywhere. It was terrible. It was bad. I looked for a job. I couldn't find it. I gave up at some point, etc. I just couldn't be bothered anymore. I went, I did whatever I could just to make to get by. Then I came into KICC, Lord have mercy, and I sat under the administration of our pastor, Pastor Matthew Shimulo, and before you knew, my courage came back, my strength came back. I went to look for that certificate and dusted it. The same certificate that they said no to. Glory be to God. Doors began to open, and that was the last time I experienced that kind of hardship and difficulties, etc. Because I accepted at one time, and looking back now, I was operating at the Sons of Men. There's not enough job in the city. There's no job anywhere. The economy is bad. This is bad. That is keeping company with the Sons of Men. Trading stories of disappointment. That's not your portion in Jesus' name. You have to come out of them. Glory be to God. Come out of that park. Oh, glory be to God, and begin to operate as sons of God. When you begin to operate as daughters of God, you begin to see what the sons of men don't see, what the daughters of men don't see. You hear a new sound. Oh, glory be to God. Yakadisi, Bredidibozo. Didn't you see Elijah? He had the sound of rain. After several years, there has been no rain. When nobody had anything, but he had the sound of rain. Oh, glory be to God. Sons of God, daughters of God, they operate on a different level. Ladies and gentlemen, your Christianity will be wishy-washy. However we want to play, as long as you operate as sons of men. If you begin to operate as sons of God, then you begin to see signs and wonder. You will surprise yourself. Oh, glory be to God. Why? Because creation is waiting. Let's give them something to see. Oh, hallelujah. Creation is waiting. The angels are waiting. Does this man know who he is? Does this woman know who he is? They are waiting on you. Send me something to do. Give me work to do. Oh, some people's angels have gone on holiday. No. God forbid bad thing. No, it's time to begin to take control. Oh, to begin to declare the word by faith. Whilst we look not at the things which are seen, for the things that are seen are temporary, the things that are not seen are eternal. Begin to operate as sons and daughters of God. Manifestation of the sons and daughters of God. Oh, glory be to God. That is the plan of God for your life. That is the will of God for your life. I think I'm going to stop here because of time. By God's grace, we will continue on this series until it sinks into your spirit, sinks into your knower, that you know that you are indeed the son of God, that indeed you are a daughter of God. So a no, when the son of man tells you a no to a son of God, who are you talking to? Oh, glory be to, I'm just hearing him. Even my mind is shifting as I'm sharing this. Some unbeliever tells you you can't achieve that, you can't do. Who are you? Do you know who I am? I'm a son of God. As for sons of God, nothing is impossible for them. I'm a daughter of God. And for daughters of God, nothing is impossible for them. So you are just a son of man. And I'm superior to you until you get saved, that is. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. I feel so excited in my spirit. I just pray for you out there. If you've surrendered, if you've given up, if you've given or surrendered because you've been buffeted by the challenges of life, I pray for courage, for strength to come into you one more time. In the name of Jesus, like Samson, oh, when he shook his head and the head has grown back, he carried the bulls. I said, God, just this one last time. The strength came back and he got rid of all his enemies. You will not perish with your enemy in Jesus' name, but receive strength to recover in the name of Jesus. We must know who we are. We must know and show the world who we are. We are sons of the Most High God without any apologies. We call the shots. Oh, glory to God. That's your portion. We call the shots in Jesus' name. Amen. I feel so excited in my spirit. I'm sure you are blessed as indeed as I am. Glory be to God. We'll bring it to a close for now. And continue by God's grace next week. Let's take the opportunity to worship the Lord with our tithes, with our offerings, with our pledges, and with our vow. Look, let's say this. God is not mocked. That which a man sows, that shall they also reap. God is blessing you, and the reason why God wants to bless you is so that He can bless His kingdom. You cannot go to unbelievers to ask them to give towards God's work. That will not take faith. But God will bless you, and as He blesses you, God expects you to bless His work. And if you truly say you love God, you will do that. I pray that may God meet you at the point of your need. May God bless you. May God increase you. May Yahweh empower you. In Jesus' name. Just a couple of announcements, and then we'll bring this to a close. Please, let's remember to join our pastor in the Lord, Mr. Matthew Shimon, for the morning glow. You can't afford to start your day without the morning glow. It's such a breath of fresh air, the best way to ever start. So please remember, let us join him every day, Monday to Friday, 6 a.m. to 7 a.m. You'll be blessed as you do so, in Jesus' name. Please also
let us support the initiative, Africa's biggest rural crusade. It's going on, it's happening the 6th to 11th of November.
To be part of this, I think I have the platform to be able to give
to support this. If you can't go physically, or if you can, as well as give towards it, please, wherever you are around the world, you are able to do this. Please make sure you do, and you know, take a screen grab of this and give as much as you can. What you make happen to others, God will happen for you too.
In Jesus' name, amen. That brings me to our next program
that is coming up in 2 weeks' time, 23rd of September. It's a worship night. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be wonderful. I want to encourage you, if you're not registered to come, please register on the Eventbrite. KS is the city of refuge. If you put that in, it will come up so that you can register. It's a free event. We're just creating an atmosphere of worship, intimate moment of worship with God, excess worship, a time to really just lavish God with our worship, with our praise. You don't want to miss it for anything. So I want to encourage you to do the best you can. Tell your friends, tell your family that
place to be, in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. And I think that's it. Until next time, may the Lord bless you, may the Lord increase you, may Yahweh empower you, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.